As Zen mentioned to all of you yesterday, those of you who were here, Maulana has been kind enough and gracious enough for the time that he's here this Ramadan to spend his Friday nights and Saturday nights after the program with us. Each night he has put together a discussion on a topic of that we've chosen. Tonight's program will be on the topic of Vilayat. One of the things that Maulana mentioned yesterday that you all should keep in mind is that this is an informal program, meaning you are more than welcome to ask questions at any time. If you do have a question, just feel free to raise your hand. I know it's a little dark so you all can see the slideshow, but feel free to raise your hand and you can ask any questions you like. Also, if you would like copies of the slides, I'd be more than happy to provide them to you. Just let me know after the program and I'll get anyone who needs a copy. Thank you. I'd like to now introduce Maulana Sahib to begin the program. Salat.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Wa bihi nasta'in wa huwa an-nasirul mu'in. Yesterday we talked about imamat and we said we'll tell you today what is the difference between imamat and wilayat. I was really tired yesterday. I'm a little bit less tired than yesterday today, so my brain is working a bit better. Imamat, the word imam is from amam. We have all of those sisters talking at the back. Not in here, but
shut the door.
Just like in English and in Urdu, we have names for the directions. In Arabic, front and back. Front is amam and back is khalf. Amam. Everyone listening? So amam is front and khalf is back. Yameen, right, and yasar, left. So front is amam. Amamakum. Who is in front of you? Man amamakum. Wa man khalfakum. And who is behind you? So amam and khalf. Therefore we have two terms. Imam and Khalifa. The one who is in front is called Imam, taken from the word Amam, Amama. From Amam, it is Imam. The one who stands in front, who leads, is called an Imam. And Khalifa, the one who has been left behind by someone else. So Khalifa to Rasul is the one who he left behind. And Imam is the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent to be a leader in front of you. If you place the one who is in an imam behind you, you're going against the rule of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the one who's been left behind by the Holy Prophet, if you place them to be lower than yourselves or put another person in their place, then again, the whole concept is lost. Further on that, when Imam Ali al-Islam was asked that, we are asked, what do you believe Ali to be, fourth Khalifa or the first Khalifa? And if we say the first, then they know straight away that we are Shias and then we'll be punished. This is for taqiyya. In America, there is no taqiyya, I promise you. But in certain places, in some other countries, there will be taqiyya. There is still taqiyya. The Imam al-Islam said, "Ana rabiul khulafa." I'm the fourth of the khulafa. Whenever someone asks you, what number is Ali on the khilafat, you say number four. That is based on the Holy Quran. Because the Quran says, the first khalifa is inni ja'ilun fil ardi khalifa. The first khalifa, according to Quran, is Adam. Allah said, I'm sending a khalifa on earth. Secondly, Hazrat Musa said, O Allah, give me a man who is from my family, yakunu li khalifa, who is going to be my khalifa. That was Harun. The second khalifa is Harun. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Dawud, Ya Dawud, inni ja'aluka lil-nas khalifa. Khalifatan fil ard. Inni ja'aluka khalifatan fil ard. I'm making you a khalifa on earth. So the third khalifa is Dawud. And then he said, Istakhlifhum fil ladhi. Istakhlifhum fil ard. The Quran says, leave behind the khalifa to the Holy Prophet. And that is me, the fourth khalifa from the Holy Quran. So the first one is Adam, second one is Harun, third one is Dawood, and the fourth one is Imam Ali alayhi salam, based on the Holy Quran. But after the Holy Prophet, we do not intend that he was a fourth. He was a first. Okay? He was deprived of his right. So this is Imamat and Khilafat. Now, there is a book, I'm not sure if it has a translation into English, but it is an excellent piece of work on the topic of Imamat and Khilafat. by Allama Sayyid Murtaza Askari, who passed away last month of Ramadan. So it's been 1 year now on his death. May Allah have blessing on him. Rahmatullahi alayhi. He was 95 when he died and he was still serving. I remember one last meeting with him. We were all students from, 102 different countries. And we went to him and we met him and he was an old man, elderly, sitting down and he could not hear properly. So he said, you have to speak loudly so I can hear you. So I was explaining to him who everyone is, where they're from. And he was asking them, how many followers of Ahlul Bayt do you have in your country? What do you do for the sake of Ahlul Bayt? Are there any people giving you problems? He said, okay, one promise I want to make to you. Allama Sayyid Murtaza Askari. He said, if there is any time people ask you question on the Maktab of Ahlul Bayt, the school of thought of the Ahlul Bayt, and you do not have answers, then send them to me and I'll answer them for you. Even in that old age, at the age of 93, 94, look at the courage he had to serve, the strength and the love for Ahlul Bayt that he would still serve. So that's that. He has a book called Ma'alim al-Madrasa Thing, the teachings of the two schools of thought. He says, to say Shia and Sunni is wrong. There are two schools of thought. The school of thought of the Khulafa and the school of thought of Imamat. The ones who believed after the Holy Prophet and the Khulafa, the first, the second, and the third, and then Muawiyah to be Khalifa, then Yazid to be Khalifa, then Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, Marwan, all of those people to be Khulafa. He said, they are that school of thought, and there is the Imami school of thought, who believe in the A'imma, alayhi salam. So these are two schools of thought. It has a translation into Urdu, Maktabi Imamat al-Khilafat. That is an excellent piece of work on Imamat al-Khilafat. Now today, when we talked about Imamat yesterday, we said we'll tell you the difference between Imamat and Vilayat. Khilafat, I've told you now. Imamat and Khilafat. Is everyone here?
Yes.
Wherever you have a question, just raise your hand and then you can just give a comment or ask a question. So that was Imamat and Khilafat. Now Imamat and Vilayat. Imamat means divine leadership. When other than Shia say Imamat, what comes to their mind is something different than when we say Imam. Then something different comes to our minds. I'll be using that in a minute. If you're looking to me, please. You look at the screen and I'll tell you to. Imam, when we say Imam, not just a person who leads the prayers or something like that comes to our mind. Imam, when we say Imam, the 12 Imams come to our mind. So that is the divine imams. Divine leaders are called imams. The ones who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the authority to lead are imams. In Arabic, singular is imam and plural is a'imma. وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ a'immatan فِي الْأَرْضِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we have made them the imams on the surface of the earth بِمَا صَبَرُوا. Because of their patience and because of their knowledge and all the arguments, which I don't want to go into tonight. So that is imamat. What is wilayat? Wilayat is translated as authority. Imamat, leadership, and wilayat, authority. Now the Sunnis say wilayat is love or friendship. That's why we have actually taken it as an independent topic. They believe in the verses that were revealed for Imam Ali alayhi salatu wasalam for wilayat. But they say their difference with us is on the meaning of wilayat. What does it mean to be the wali of Allah? What does it mean to have the wilayat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They say it means you should love them. That is the basic thing. This verse is the most important verse. The ones who ask you, why do you say Ali and Waliullah? Always give them this verse. Very easy to remember. How many are the panchatan? So this surah is 555. Verse number 55. 555. Easy to remember, isn't it? And if any one of you forget, then you should be, I don't know. Okay? So the verse is, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Innama waliyukum Allahu wa rasuluhu walladheena aamanu alladheena yuqeemuna salata wa yutuna zakata wa hum raki'un. Memorize this verse, it is for Imam Ali alayhi salam. Every Sunni has accepted, almost. You'll get the black sheep everywhere. There'll be an old one who will say, no, I won't accept it. They won't say who it is for, but they say, I know it's not for Imam Ali alayhi salam. So they'll say some Tom, Dick and Harry's name in it and then... three Tom, Dick and Harry, there's a term in English. No indications, please. So this verse was revealed for Imam Ali alayhi salam. Imam Jarullah Zamakhshari. Remember the names and inshallah you can take down the notes. Imam Jarullah Zamakhshari.